Whoa.
Look at this. It's amazing.
This is intense.
Would you all mind signing in at the desk, please?
This isn't everything.
I'm sure the rest is almost here. I'll make sure it gets to your rooms.
Kate's makeup case is slowing it down.
Erin, cigarettes.
Blue backpack.
Settle in, and I'll meet you all at dinner. At 8.
Mr. Dumais, I cannot say thank you enough times. This is truly fantastic. I told you all this was a good plan, didn't I? I told you.
Busy. You've been out and about all day. And I have to sit here worrying. Gone all day and not a word from you.
Oh!
Sorry. You're jumpy.
Oh my god. I think I peed a little.
How did you not hear me coming?
I don't think we're the only ones here.
Kate saw a little girl looking out a window at us when we were outside.
That's who I saw. A little girl.
Mr. Demet probably has family, a staff, maybe friends. Who knows? That said, this place does give me the willies.
It's unique.
Were you singing?
Oh, yeah, that's my being scared song. This is my don't be scared song. Sing it and I won't be scared long. Doesn't really work.
I bet.
181. I think I'm around the corner.
183? This is me.
Okay.
Okay. Good luck out there. Don't get lost. Scream if you need me for anything.
Thanks.
I got you.
Nothing to be scared of.
Actually, hey.
Yeah?
Why don't you hang a second while I unpack, then I can help you find your room? Something about this place makes me want to use the buddy system.
Yes. Thanks. I'd end up lost, probably.
It's just a hall, dude. Are.
Well, it's, cozy?
Cozy is fun. If we have to double up like last time, we'd be married by morning.
You talk in your sleep. Not sure I ever told you that.
Sure. What did I say?
Actually, it was just a bunch of incoherent swearing.
Oh, I was awake. I was reading Kate's social media posts. Ugh, that bitch.
Okay, don't hate me, but she's been kind of nice to me. I mean, I think she's more upset about Mark than she lets on.
Lies. She's a robot.
Where's the bathroom?
Wait, what?
Old school.
Gross school? What if I have to pee in the middle of the night? Am I gonna walk in on Charlie sitting on the pot?
Guess that means there's no mini bar either.
Shows what you know.
What is that?
Wine, genius.
I feel like if we start drinking, Charlie will find out and lecture me and make me feel like an asshole again.
Yeah, he does that. But we're not on the clock. Not until we're rigging to shoot.
Which is hard to do drunk.
I'm not suggesting we get full-on hammered before we work.
Why are you doing that?
I'm thirsty. Also, you're cute when you're worked up.
I don't... Cute? You think I'm cute?
Hmm?
Oh.
Gotta stick on my own if you want to share lip cooties.
Thanks, but I can find mine.
Where'd it go?
It's all the way against the wall. See it?
You okay?
Shit.
You trying to scare me now?
No.
Revenge? Because good job. You sure you're okay? Because, yeah, maybe me scaring you didn't help, did it?
No. But seriously, it's not your fault. I try to pretend like it isn't a thing, you know? Like, I don't want to be depending on an inhaler. I try to mind over matter it, but dust and allergies, and I just need to be more careful.
You sure?
Sure. I'm sure. So, yeah. Cozy. You gonna try that? And now you're poisoned.
It's not that bad.
You're not lying?
It's piquant. Decent vintage.
Sure.
I'm getting... oaky undertones, a hint of citrus. Oh. And I want to say a strong, healthy amount of moldy sweat socks.
Oh my God, I hate you. You are such a liar.
Oh, sorry. I thought you meant the thinking you were cute thing. Really?
If my cheeks are red, it's from this wine. Not because I am bashful. I swear. Really.
Sorry. Didn't mean to make you feel weird.
Yeah, it's just... we work together, and Charlie is always on me about being more professional and...
I get it.
No, I mean, I'm not saying I don't appreciate it. Or that I don't think you're cute, too. It's just,
What are you doing?
Oh, my God. Oh, you bitch!
I'm just fucking with you. I wanted to kiss you for months. I just was scared to make a real move. Sorry.
Who is that?
Enjoying yourself out here like some sort of pervert?
Sorry, did I interrupt something here?
No, we're just talking shop. We're worried about the power grid handling all of our gear.
Yeah, yes. If this place is running on a generator, we need to know what it's putting out.
I don't care what you guys are doing.
Then why are you lurking?
I can't find my room, and I need a fucking cigarette.
These funny shapes are numbers. They go up and down in order.
Thank you. I've just been down there. Look, give me 10, then we should get a rough plan for getting our first shot.
We have all evening. Can't we plan after dinner? I'd like to chill for a minute after the trek getting here.
I want to be shooting after dinner. You've got 10 minutes.
Okay. We'll be down in a few then.
Oh, Erin, I checked my blue bag. No cigarettes.
That's where I put them.
Come and show me. Maybe one of us is colorblind and doesn't know what a blue bag is.
To be continued, then?
Yes, definitely.
Good luck finding your rooms. Where the hell are they going?
Well?
I'm looking. Oh, Kate wanted you to have this.
Breaking down walls, navigating the maze of anxiety. Are you fucking kidding me?
I think she thought it might help with your stress, or...
Absolutely not. I'm not stressed, okay? Do I look fucking stressed? That was rhetorical.
Well, your cards came out nice enough.
Oh, yeah. Embossing. Makes a huge difference.
You old guys love business cards. Old school. You old school guys.
I also put it on heavy stock and did the logo in foil. Damn. I should have had one ready for Mr. Dumet. Did you find them?
No. I swear I put them in here. I don't understand.
Jesus. Check the other bag.
Didn't you already?
Just look.
It's only clothes and, this. Notice of eviction. The studio?
I paid the studio rent out the wrong account and the check bounced. It's nothing. I just have to use another... It's fine.
So you're saying not to worry?
Worry about finding my bloody cigarettes.
They're gone, Charlie.
Gone? Just like that? Are you saying somebody took them?
I don't...
Actually, I can see Kate doing that. Or Jamie.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. Let's just get on with things. This place is massive. Surely there is a pack of cigarettes in here somewhere. Even if they're ancient.
You need them that bad?
There was a bar off the lobby. There must be cigarettes in the bar, right?
I mean, technically, it's not legal to smoke in bars, so...
Come on, we're checking. If you find them first, all will be forgiven.
So, I know you said it wasn't a thing, but that bank notice...
You're fixating, which normally I applaud, but not about this.
I mean, you'd tell us if we were in danger of losing our jobs, right?
It's television. Everyone is always in danger of losing their jobs.
Sure, but...
It's fine. Erin, please. I've squared it all with the network. We're still working on this final episode, and they're paying your salary, not me.
Well, but...
You have to let this go. We're fine, Erin, okay? Got to be worth something. Thank you.
Hey, Charlie. I was hoping next season maybe I could do more with the sound design, more creative stuff.
Erin, what you already do for this company is very valuable to us.
Carrying your bags and picking up your laundry?
Absolutely. To get ahead in this industry, you have to pay your dues. Show you're ready to muck in.
I think you should get an assistant.
An assistant?
Oh, it was just a stupid idea, Charlie. I'm just...
An assistant? A personal assistant?
Sort of. And then I could help out with the editing.
Pardon me? The editing?
The audio mix. Look, I just think you've got so much to give, so much experience. And it's an opportunity to pass that knowledge on.
Right. Yes, I suppose it is. And an assistant wouldn't lose my cigarettes, would they?
Exactly. So, do you still want to direct movies, Charlie?
I am directing.
No, but I mean real movies. With a big budget and big stars.
Erin, there's something important that you have to understand. In the work that we do, the very important work, the truth is the star.
Oh, right. Yeah, sorry, Charlie. So you don't want to direct movies?
Can we move on from this?
Hey, maybe Mr. Dumet is in the back office. You could just ask him about cigarettes.
Thank you.
jackpot.
Erin, I found the key.
Why don't I go check for a gift shop or something? I've already had one asthma attack today, and this dust farm is exactly what I don't need.
A gift shop might have cigarettes.
Exactly.
Atta girl.
Hello?
Mr. Dumet?
Hello?
Good morning to you all. I'm Chester Bell, Assistant Director at the Federal Bureau of Investigation. At approximately 0530 local time, a team led by Special Agent Hector Monday and supported by law enforcement officers conducted a raid of a motel room just outside Birmingham, Alabama, to apprehend Manny Sherman, the man known as the Beast of Arkansas. Using state-of-the-art psychological profiling techniques, Special Agent Monday and members of his task force not only identified their suspect, but predicted his movement with unerring accuracy. I'm delighted to say, we have our man.
Wow! An animatronic! Ha! That's amazing!
What will it be, Mr. Dumet, sir?
I'll have a packet of cigarettes, please. A packet of cigarettes, please. Hello? Hello? A packet of smokes?
Figured it was too good to be true. Never mind. Thank you, Robo Bowman.
Certainly, sir. Whatever you wish.
No fucking way.
Thank you very much, my mechanical friend. Much appreciated.
Yes! Yes!
Of course it wants exact change. Damn it!
Next round's on me. Promise. Life would be so much easier with that in my jacket pocket. What? No! No, please! I'm having a really shit day, and you've just made it worse. Thank you, Lord. Ha! What? No, come on, you piece of shit. Don't do this to me. Antique rubbish. Give them to me. Give me my cigarettes! Right, you. That's it. I'm gonna go and get my key grip, and they are gonna kick the shit out of you.
Hey, Charlie.
Yeah, I'm still in the bar.
I think it's dinner time. We should get everyone else.
Okay, I'm coming.
And I'm coming back for you with a fucking pry bar.
Are you alone in there? Who's that behind the bar?
What?